Saturday, July 21, 2018, 3 a.m. 78 degrees Fahrenheit, 6 a.m. 76 degrees Fahrenheit. 5-day forecast. 9 members of the same family are among 17 killed in duck boat tragedy after ticket mix-up put them on the wrong boat, as survivors reveal how they were trapped under canopy as it sank, and were then sucked under as they tried to swim away. George H.W. Bush's heart doctor is shot and killed while riding his bike on Houston Hospital campus by another cyclist in shocking daylight attack. Instagram now shows a green dot next to your username so people know when you're a Trump, says NFL players who kneel during the anthem twice should be banned for the season, and urges $40 million Commissioner Roger Goodell to take a stand. Xanax could be driving America's next drug epidemic. Top psychiatrist warns addictive anti-anxiety meds are being dished out like opioids were in the 90s, and patients are struggling to quit. Cardi B's convicted felon husband offset in jail after arrest for carrying a gun on probation. Robert Mueller subpoenas notorious Manhattan madam who worked with Trump aide Roger Stone and was embroiled in the prostitution that brought down Elliot Spitzer. Trump's new communications chief was questioned under subpoena by a federal grand jury over his handling of UAL harassment when he was a top Fox News executive. Coates has gone rogue. White House fears fallout if spy chief were to resign in protest after getting blindsided about Putin visit. During live interview, "I have nothing to do with Russia. I never did." Trump says his meeting with Putin is in the works and slams collusion claims as a big fat hoax. Piers Morgan: "Whisper it, but despite his terrible week, Trump may be absolutely right to pursue this new bromance with Putin." Kimberly Guilfoyle is replaced by Katie Pavlich on The Five just 1 hour after she is let go by Fox News and not allowed on air to say goodbye. Rep. Devin Nunes used political donations to fund lavish dinners and limo rides, including $15,000 on Boston Celtics tickets. Trump claims that China and the EU have been manipulating their currencies in new assault, accusing them of taking away America's competitive edge. "You've got a friend in me." Secretary of State Mike Pompeo backs the president's plan to bring Putin to the White House, saying, "I think this makes enormous sense." Ex-spy serving in Congress claims Trump is being manipulated by Putin and participated in a Russian disinformation campaign. Russia's ambassador to the U.S. says Trump and Putin discuss letting a referendum take place in separatist-leaning eastern Ukraine. Merkel insists she will not quit in bitter fight over migration and says Trump is not her enemy as she vows to heal transatlantic relations. There are tapes. Michael Cohen made a recording of conversation with Trump about Playboy model who claims she had affair with Trump and took $150,000 payment. Trump steps up his attack on the Fed plan to raise interest rates, accusing it of making the U.S. uncompetitive by strengthening the dollar. "Like mother, like daughter." A pajama-clad Arabella Kushner grins widely as she carries her father's bag out to the car, minutes before a beaming Ivanka struts her stuff in a chic white dress pictured at Trump's inauguration. The red-headed Russian spy who offered for access and infiltrated the NRA on Kremlin orders, and lived with John Wayne Bobbitt's rep. "A woman can behave as a slut, but you can't call her a slut." Shocking 2012 radio clip of Republican congressman complaining about using ES label sparks after resurfacing revealing portrait of Prince George on his 5th birthday. Granny Carol feeds him chips and sweets. He is obsessed with volcanoes and is seeing more and more of Granddad Charles. By Ross McDonough for DailyMail.com. Published 2100 Eastern Daylight Saving Time, the 20th of July 2018. Updated 2104 Eastern Daylight Saving Time, the 20th of July 2018. Khloe Kardashian has apologized for calling her sister Kourtney the word retard in her Instagram Live. The 34-year-old took to Twitter to apologize on Friday after fans called her out for calling her sister Kourtney a f**king retard. The siblings were trying to set up an Instagram live of their exercise routine on Thursday morning, but were having difficulty with the technical side. Mea culpa. The 34-year-old took to Twitter to apologize on Friday after fans called her out for calling her sister Kourtney a f**king retard. Kourtney can be heard telling her younger sis, "Yes, you can u f**king retard," while Khloe back a u f**king retard aide. A number of fans were offended by her poor choice of words. "You should pay more attention to your word choices, especially since you have a huge following. Don't know who you could be offending," one wrote. "If True had a disability, you would use a different word." But Khloe was quick to hold up her hand and accept responsibility. "Mind your mouth." The siblings were trying to set up an Instagram live of their exercise routine on Thursday morning, but were having difficulty with the technical side. Language. Kourtney can be heard telling her younger sis, "Yes, you can u f**king retard," while Khloe back a u f**king retarded. "Uff, I hate that word. Why did I even say that? You are 1,000,000% right, and I actually greatly dislike when people use that word," she responded. "I will do better. I am sorry." Much love today, she added. The KUWT K-star was immediately applauded for the way she handled the situation. Now this is the way you are accountable for your actions and apologize. Much respect to you for realizing what you said was wrong and owning up to it. One wrote, "It's so difficult to break a habit like that, but so much respect for really trying and owning up to mistakes." Another added, "Owned up." A number of fans were offended by her poor choice of words, and she immediately apologized. Advertisement, don't miss.